We shall not rest till wars are done. Remember, friends, the world is one. Although we hail from different lands, we share one earth and sky and sun. Remember, friends, the world is one.
This is from the Vice President, Jerry Sankey.
Yes, yeah, and today is the 4th of March, 2070. Yeah. I think it's the birthday of the GOA President, yes. Mr. Juman Yassin.
Okay, okay, wow. Yes. That's good. My good, very good friend. Yes, my very, very good friend. Yes.
Now, among the issues that we have the Minister of Public Infrastructure promising that a situation where GPL's transmission and distribution problems will be solved by year-end.
Yes.
Said international firms will assist him to do this. By the end of 2017, he's promising that there will be an end to the problems, transmission and distribution problems.
So we get better electricity.
No blackouts.
Yeah, okay.
Now,
very good.
City Hall has doubled their earnings in January.
Yes.
Now, this doesn't include, they haven't disclosed anything with the parking meters. This is about fees for compliance certificates and building approvals. They're the things that have helped to increase the revenue. And we see UGs to get $100 million for oil and gas training for this year as well. Oil and gas training, University of Guyana. I think the Vice Chancellor developed a close relationship too with the Public Sector Commission member, Mr. Gavaya.
Yes.
Yeah, the Vice Chancellor seemed to be very close friends.
He's my friend too.
Jerry Gavaya. And the sugar future will be considered at National Assembly. What is going to happen with the sugar industry? And as I said, going back to that parking meter thing, they need to scrap it. But it's before the court now. And I think the judge, after listening to the arguments, will decide that let us start all over again. But I insist that the Public Utilities Commission should be the decider with prices. They shouldn't be allowed, nobody should be allowed to increase prices like that, just like with electricity and water. The PUC, the Public Utilities Commission, should be involved in that.
I mean, I get understanding increasing garbage in the street, increasing the price and garbage. Why people not pay tax? People don't pay tax.
They're supposed to be paying. But there are a lot of business people who have not. I don't know if they have failed to enforce in courts, but the City Hall needs to take more people, to have more people paying. Find some way of getting them to pay. Or if they don't pay, they might have to seize some property or something. You know?
Mr. Mark.
Mr. Sharma.
Yes, let me hear what you'd like to see now.
It's good to see you.
Yes. Welcome.
It's good to always be in Georgetown.
Yes.
Always in my heart.
Yes.
I've been watching you and Sankey and the other panel members on YouTube.
Yes.
So I know what's going on.
Oh, yes.
These are interesting times in Georgetown.
Yes. Yes.
Many challenges for people with different pricing changes. But I want to give a salute today to a wonderful lady named Vanessa in Queenstown, who runs the Hot and Spicy Creole Corner. This is a businesswoman that started small, serving a few dishes and she's celebrating her 12th anniversary.
Congratulations.
12th anniversary. Today. So, Vanessa and the wonderful team, congratulations. In spite of what comes at you, you've worked and you built a wonderful corner, four different places to eat. It's a wonderful anniversary. And, you know, I have to say.
That's third in Albert Street.
Another third in Albert Street. You're exactly right. And another anniversary for you. 25 years.
Okay. Now, wait in the process with Donald Trump. What do you think of President Donald Trump?
Well, it'll light the phones up for the next 10 hours.
He's keeping his promises.
Donald Trump.
Yes.
Now, we spent some time on him when I was here last before and after the election. And there were people like this, and there were some people who called in who are very hostile. Now, I just want you to know, my name is not Donald Trump Jr., all right? I'm not Eric Trump. I want you to know that. Donald Trump is, number one, doing what he said he would do.
Yes.
And he is enforcing the law. There were 21 people deported back to Guyana March the 3rd, right here, dropped off at the airport, brought to your police, brought to your police station. My question would be, I hope your police will take the documents in regard to the crimes of the people and vet them for this society not to be broken like our American society was. So he's enforcing the law. Now, we have a Democratic Party and a Republican Party, and the Democratic Party seems not to like his ruling to enforce the law. But the majority, the silent majority, has been very in favor of his leadership and what he's doing. This Russia thing, boy, it's kind of like parking meters. It just flares up. And the thing is, Mr. Sharma, in Washington, D.C., there are Russian diplomats, diplomats of every country talking to our senators, our congresspeople. Recently, Britt Hume of Fox News tweeted and said, why, just last month, Senator Feinstein from California was having lunch with a Russian diplomat. I didn't think anything about it. You know, it's just the way it is. So there's a lot of hate from political parties. Politics can be, as you know, very difficult, very hateful. And so that and the media, Mr. Trump is not letting the media beat him up. He's firing back. You dish it out, I dish it back out. So right now in America, there is some unrest. There's some pressure we feel.
I think there's a lot of property immigrants, not in Guyana, the whole country, whole world. Immigrant.
Yeah, and so we're just trying to be ones in America to protect our borders as you would want to protect your borders with Venezuela or Suriname, but we want to protect the people. Justice for all.
The people come first.
The people are first.
Yeah, that's right.
And so if Trump says America first, well, you who are watching should say Guyana first, or you who are Brazilian residents working here, Brazil first. So protect the people.
Yes.
Let the people's voices speak. The phones are open. Call in.
Mom, what is your name?
Scott, Mr. Scott.
Where are you from?
Barica.
Barica. Yes. What part of Barica?
Brackets, I'm going to the outfall.
You have welcome to your program before?
Yeah, I'm a regular.
Okay. Tell me what is your problem now?
Well, my problem is to let the public know we have a problem with the social work or welfare in the country in general.
And that's what you do?
Yeah. Okay. I'm a social worker, community worker. And I find it very difficult to understand that. We have these people at different region, which is Port Rhine, Miss Green office in Broad Street, and Lamar, the head office there. Things are not going the way it should, because when the president sent me the letter concerning the issue, they claim that it's missing. So if they are the office and the president sent a letter and letter missing, that means something is wrong. Well, number two, we have kids that have been abused. Yeah. We have domestic problem with husband not dutiful to wife. The young people just get a problem with the mother-in-law and so on, in-laws.
Yes.
So it's very hard to cope with. Yes. We got to know how to deal with this situation.
Yes.
And they must be able to come out and reach the people, not sit in office there.
That's right.
I make a report to them that my daughter took my son to her parents in Escribo. And the sister in Escribo hide the children, two daughters.
What?
to hide all the children from him.
So say that again for our viewers.
Yeah.
Your daughter took your...
My daughter-in-law took my son to Essequibo. Yeah.
Your daughter-in-law took your son to Essequibo. What happened?
Yeah.
Well, he normally sell antenna deer. So he said that, Mom, I'm going to Essequibo. So I told Warner, I said, girl, Carmen, Sonito, don't take my son to your stepfather because when you go there, he's running with a cutlass.
And why you running to cutlass?
Well, that is his attitude.
Yes.
He's our attitude.
What the purpose? Police are involved?
We end up at the station. Yes. I myself was their mother when I received a message and go there.
Yes.
And the police...
What the police did?
They received the call and they locked him up.
Yes.
Well, after they said they were going to charge him, I begged for him.
Why you beg for him?
He's a big man and I'm sorry for him.
No,
but he kept doing it over and over.
More than one time?
Yeah, this is the fourth time he's doing it.
Lock him up.
So I think something got to be done.
And what is the offense?
Is that he don't... when you say offense, what do you mean?
The allegation you mean like
oh, that my grandchildren missing. Yeah. When they go there, they hide the children, lock them up, and send them away to the children.
Yes.
So as a father with girl children, things happening to bad to children of today.
Yes.
Especially they do bad things to little girls. So I'm coming to work. I know what is going on with little girls.
Yes.
So I scared my baby is 6 months old. And the girl is 2 years old.
Yes.
And my only granddaughter is them.
Yes.
And I spent a lot of money on them because of care.
Yes.
You spend because you care.
Mm-hmm.
And I have another daughter home, it's 2 daughters.
Okay.
And I gave them the best treatment.
Okay.
And I wanted to know what is the reason why family always come between like sister-in-law and other come taking away children. This is wrong. And it's not a matter for Essequibo, it's region. This thing works through region.
Yes.
If you live at Perico, the issue is for Podrine. So apparently they are cooking up things at the probation.
Where
is it happened? It happened at Perico.
Who cooking up these things? Who cooking up?
The welfare in Essequibo.
Oh, yeah, welfare in Essequibo course.
Yes, like she going out talk their own thing.
Yes.
And I'm the hide off my grandchildren. Okay. And what I'm saying, the police, I run in there up and down a night to sleep at Saudi Hospital on the bench.
Why you had to sleep there?
Because he said that when he went over there, he gone to drop an tent and tell her to stay at the parents.
Yeah.
When he go receiving them, I chase him. So he go to complain at the station. He said he get locked up.
Yes.
So I said, what? The sergeant very nice there. I talked to him.
What did you know, sergeant?
I don't know his name.
Okay, go ahead.
But he talked to me, and I was satisfied the way things handled.
Yes.
I called commanding too. They sent him home. They said go to Perico station and welfare got deal with it. But I'm vexed with welfare, Podrine. I went there and make a report that he made the child and the domestic problem.
Okay.
All they do, they said, give me a letter that appointment.
Okay.
You appointing this is 3 weeks and no, I cannot see my baby. And baby need milk. They are very poor. The girls go in bush.
How many babies you have? Babies?
The baby is a little 6 months baby girl and the 2 year girl. It's my grandchildren, but the two Indian boys, I care for them.
Okay.
I do a lot for them. But I believe why she did this, because she don't take them to clinic.
Okay.
And I said, I cannot be a welfare officer, and you and me and baby not go to clinic.
Okay.
And the little boys,
Sankeys, we will talk about the education now. What do you think about the education system? Because it didn't go in case in this country. Okay, the education system.
Yes, but as I said, education is for the development of the people, so you can develop the nation.
Yes.
You know, when you educate, you want to see more educated people who could get jobs.
Yeah.
But I think there should be no way.
Yes.
My personal view is that we should not tax even private education, you know, because it's so important. We want to have educated people in the country, you know, serving this country and to stay here.
Yes.
You know, but what happens when there are no jobs? Many of them go abroad. We lose a lot of people to the outside world because they don't stay here. First of all, there's no job in many cases. Then the salaries are not adequate enough here. I remember teachers going, a lot of teachers were taken over around 2000, year 2000, went to work in the States and never returned.
Yeah. Right.
And also in the Caribbean, places like St. Martin offer you about 4 or 5 times what you earn here.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Even high school level. So, people are not going to stay here if we continue this way.
Mark, what do you think about the education system in Guyana? Throw the world. Throw the world now.
You know, I believe in education today.
Yeah.
It will build a great future tomorrow.
Yes.
So we have to have education.
Yes.
Education should not be taxed.
Mm.
Textbooks should not be taxed. Literature that will educate people should not be taxed. And so it's a culture. Education is a culture. Education is an atmosphere.
Yeah.
So listening to Ms. Carter here, certainly there needs to be an education about what a family is. Yeah. Because she explained a very broken situation.
Right. Yeah, right.
And we don't learn just by what we hear. We don't learn just by what we see.
Yes.
What is caught is taught.
Yes.
And so if you have a group, or let's call it the generation.
Yes,
they call Sankey, they call it the millennials.
Yes.
The millennials, all they're growing up seeing that men and women don't have to be married.
Yes.
They're seeing that men can abuse girls under 18, under 16, under
small
12.
Age.
It's a rampant problem. Those are called pedophiles. And if you're a teenage girl, you should not let any man or any woman touch you in a private way at all. Period.
Can I say something about that?
Yes.
I was a candidate for election in my community.
Yeah.
And the man came from New York. His name is Hussein.
Yeah.
And where he grew up, and I'm small. So he kept came when he came at us, he said, he leave message, I must come to his home. But I focus. I don't like to visit people. So he said, I must take note when he speak.
Yes.
I didn't go. He said, I come and reach him at the end. He said, I didn't go. By the time I went to a shop now, I was speaking to some girls, young lady, because they know me as coming to
him.
And this man started fondling my breasts and pulling it up like that in the presence of the girls.
Well, isn't that called
exactly
sexual harassment?
Yes. Harassment.
Physical sexual harassment open in the public.
Yeah.
So girls and ladies said, Mom, you don't do such thing.
Okay.
You know, it's being covered up.
Okay.
I ain't get no justice on to
now. Not now.
Okay.
She just said it on the Voice of the People.
Hello?
Good afternoon, Mr. Shaw.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, yes.
Good afternoon.
Yes.
I heard you were speaking about the VAT on the private schools.
Yes,
But when VAT was introduced in the Barajabi government, they say that any business that exceeds X amount of millions is supposed to pay VAT.
Yes.
The private school exceeding amount of millions, so they're supposed to pay VAT.
Yes.
The government have free education.
Yes.
Who don't want to pay VAT, send your children back to government school. You understand?
Okay.
And they're going to be easy headache for them who's crying out for VAT.
Yes.
Then
you're
going to
pay income
back to government school. Because enough people just want to send the children to private school, and they can't afford it, and still they're trying to do it.
Okay.
Send your children to government school. Our school got the same education.
Yes.
Go private or government is what the child.
Why are you talking about income tax? Why are you talking about income tax now? Why are you talking about income tax?
Something I know, question with private or government is where your child checking in. This is
problem. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Checking in anything at anyone in the school.
Income tax. Wait, tax.
No, the private schools have been doing better than the government schools.
Thanks, Mr.
Chairman. The private schools have been doing
Call you here. Hello.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning. Yes.
I want to tell him I like the way he's conducting and saying things, which is the right thing. And the social worker there, she's doing a good job.
Yes.
We need more people to come because a lot of little children are being abused.
Yes, ma'am.
They're being abused.
Yes.
And the education system stinks in Guyana.
Yes.
And after that gentleman there, I want to tell that everybody, Mr. Chama, I want to know how come you didn't hear Trump's speech a couple of nights ago. Oh, it was wonderful.
Great speech.
Yes.
Mr. Trump?
Yes.
Yes, wonderful. Yes, yes, right. Yes, wonderful speech. Yeah, wonderful. Yes, speech.
Even some of the people that stood up on the street in Cold Street, they like what he said.
That's right.
And you know, he was very concerned with the African American children.
That's right.
And the Latino children.
Yes.
Especially in Chicago, I love what Trump said.
Okay.
All these politicians in Guyana should be looking and hearing what he said.
Yes.
You have to be a president for all people.
Okay.
You have to come out and meet the people and see their needs.
Yes.
You know, it's terrible. In Guyana, I don't know what's going on.
Oh, the Sharma got to meet the people.
Mr. Sharma, you're doing a wonderful job.
Yes.
I want to congratulate you
for
all the things you have done in the past.
Yes.
And you all have a good day.
Yeah.
Give it a gentleman. Good luck.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. You have a lovely voice and a good spirit.
Oh, thank you.
Got in here. Hello? You talk. Go ahead. You go speak.
Well, it was a good speech. And since you had asked me about Donald Trump, he did bring the tone
down. Wonderful.
He brought the tone down. He spoke from the heart. And one of the issues in America for the past several years has been school choice, because you have public school, and that has challenges too. We have private schools, and those come from business people who see a need. Many athletes start schools, but then we also have homeschool, where you have private study, just like going to university online. Well, guess what? You can send your children online or by textbooks, and you can learn in the safe environment of your home. I think what you would have to come to grips with in this country or any country, can we be wide enough to say there's more than one way to do one thing? And sometimes it takes, some children don't learn in a classroom with one teacher and 40 kids. Wonderful. Some are more artistic. Some are more musical. Some are more creative. Some can't memorize by rote, which the English system teaches. So I think, what do I think of what this lady said? I think she says step up.
Yes, right.
Step up. Look at variety. How can we impact the individual child? Okay. And the kids today got a lot more problems, Sankey, that they're facing than when you grow up.
I want to comment Donald Trump, President Donald Trump, but asking his speech you did last week.
It was a powerful speech.
Powerful speech. Very, very powerful.
And there were a lot of people that didn't think he could do it. But again, that's politics. Yes. We're always judging and we're always putting conjecture out on what we don't like and what we don't do. But if you look at it for the essence of what it was, he spoke to the issue of what he was elected for.
You know, Guyanese are attacking me because of Donald Trump. I have been attacked by Donald Trump.
Yes.
Because I attacked Donald Trump. I support Donald Trump.
Yes.
They attacked me and here.
Yes.
Terrible attack.
Why not?
Yes.
Why not?
Yes.
And I think what caught a lot of people in that speech, because you're asking about it, was the tribute he gave to the fallen soldier and his wife, the widow now, sitting in the stands. That is something Ronald Reagan started years ago, where you brought guests to the State of the Union to show that, look, man, all this politics, what do you want to say?
Yes.
Taxes, parking meters, whatever the issue is. When it all comes down to it, get past the policy, it's all about people. It all is about people. So you invite people to the gallery and say, this is how it's being lived out right now.
So I get you, President Gray, you're doing the same thing with the army, soldiers. Army.
Who?
President Gray. President Granger.
Yeah. He's doing
something with the army. People who get sick and get injured. So.
Well, you need to look after the people who serve the country.
Oh, yeah, that's
you know, they need to look after the people. They've been serving. They put out their lives for the country, and they should get.
Well, once again, it's atmosphere. Yes. It's the culture. Yes. You know, in America, we sing for the land of the free and the home of the brave. Yes. And so our hearts are toward men and women. And you know, you have Guyanese who serve. In the U.S.
Hold your line, please. Go ahead.
You have Guyanese citizens that serve the U.S. military. Yeah. So the heart of the American citizen is always to honor those men and women who serve in the military, and we're proud of them.
Yeah.
They fight for our freedoms. Got to be on the air and speak. Hello, caller. Hello, hello.
Yes.
And
hey,
Mr. Sharma,
yes.
I'd like to know what's going on at the court. Mr. Cousin Duncan, he gets charged with this thing. The court free up, now Kwame Mukai Assad Bench Cup, the court free up with a fine, because a fine is like free up.
No, that fine was very small, 20,000.
20,000.
Less offense than what Kwame Mukai do, less than that.
Yeah.
And they're doing jail, so I want to know if these magistrates in favor with the PPP people, them. No. The government are the I and these magistrates and these judges, are they making decisions only in favor of the PPP?
No.
And I can't see that this is right. Kwame Mukai Assad, the man, he pay a fine. I got a friend who was the man, not even like how Kwame Mukai Assad bench cop.
He's
doing 3 years. You understand? And I feel it's wrong. You understand? Because this is things was caused.
Well, somebody's got a different view.
Different views. Because why?
Yes.
People seeing that they're getting justice, other people getting it.
But
so
it's
unfair when the magistrates them doing with people.
But
you understand me, Mr. Sharma?
Yes. Well, some might have a different reason.
They've got another problem like what happened last year, but it's going to be more worse this
year. Thank you very much.
Yeah, there were about three.
Ask your son if you could please carry down a message to them and let them get the magistrates and all that. gotta start sentencing these people.
Thank you very much. Some might have got different.
There were about three charges.
Yes.
Because the witnesses didn't turn up, they couldn't take. There was no evidence for the two others. But destruction of the vehicle and all of that.
Yes.
But with assault, you know, the fine maybe was a bit low.
$20,000
Yes,
I would like to say something about education.
Yes.
I was a PTHM twice at the Breakers Secondary School. And my view about education is that they are saying that the kids must, I was told by the radio last week, that the kids have to go to school 15 years and 9 months. But this base school now, they take adult age, big children, and the, who leave school. So I feel this is that is a wonderful thing for the school leavers. You don't have education in the secondary, but you could go to a pay school if you want to pay.
Yeah.
Because of the age, they have a limited age now. I was told that, 15 and 9.
Yeah.
My son is at home not attending school.
Yeah.
He is 17. I went to get him in school. Education officer said, no, no. That she said is only from 15 years, 9 months. So what we have to do, not to seek the pay school if you want to educate your child.
There's adult education. But I tell you something.
The pay school, I need education.
I witnessed in St. Martin, girls going to school in their 20s, high school.
No, but
in
their
20s in high school.
No, what I'm saying, I'm talking
still in school.
About the pay school. It is very 20s. Useful
20,
for the
21,
older, the bigger age children. Mm. If they have a limited age. You still need your child to be educated. Because lots of children leave school not having no foundation, don't have not much education.
That's where the Critchlow Labour College comes in and adult classes.
So we got
to
do something.
I used to teach years ago,
too. We should support the pay school.
Yeah, I used to teach.
Because it's paid, teachers have to be there.
I
have to pay.
Yeah.
It's not doing free government.
So Sankey, is she saying that the limitation of education in this country is to only go to your how old?
15 years, 9 months, I was stolen from the...
So that's all someone has to go to school?
There's a limited amount for the age of school now. I was told that because I was seeking enrollment for my child.
Who told you that? Who told you that?
These are the public schools.
The Redo told me that.
The public schools.
Yes.
So is a 15-year-old...
To nine.
A 15 and a half-year-old...
Yeah.
Are they mature enough in the 21st century... That's all they need in education? I don't think so.
No.
I don't think so.
My son at home needs education.
I don't think so.
I'm not sure really what the requirements are, but I think they should have adult classes, adult
ongoing education.
Ongoing education. For those who missed out earlier, they must be
We like to say lifelong learning.
Lifelong learning, yeah.
Caught in here. Hello.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Yes.
I disagree with people that would say parents who have the children in private schools, if they cannot afford a bus, they'll send the children out.
Yes.
But it's not that the parents want the children to go there. If the government was so blooming, it would have never been that parents have to find that extra money to send
Good point.
Mr. Sharma,
yes.
I work at a private school.
Yes.
And the majority of parents don't pay that fees all at once.
Yes.
Pay the part.
Wonderful.
You know why they do that?
Yes, right.
Because they cannot afford to send the children to waste time in the government school.
Yes.
So this government, if they're so interested in education for the children, they should think twice about
On
education.
Children illiterate, bad.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
But they have a lot more things. It's so important that they're looking in that direction.
Direction, education.
Back on education, Mr. Sharma. This government, I don't know where we're heading, but I pray God we have somewhere that's possible.
Yes. Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you very much.
Because listen, Mr. Sharma, another thing.
Yes.
The 16% pass we were paying on certain items.
Yes.
They say they drop it to 14%.
Yes.
Look at this. They drop it at 14% and every other thing you have to pay tax on. And your salary's not raising?
Okay.
I used to be sending my husband at the shop, the grocery shop.
Yes.
$10,000 per week.
Yes.
When my husband go now, it's like $15,000 per week.
What?
Because it's additional tax money.
Yes.
But I don't know where we're heading in this place, Mr. Sharma.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Have a good afternoon.
Thank you.
She speaks strong.
Yeah.
She speaks strong.
She's
That's good.
She's very
and what she said to everyone who is listening, most private schools have a monthly or a payment plan where you can send your children, instead of paying the whole tuition, you can make a payment throughout the school year.
Karini, hello?
Good afternoon, Mr. Sawa.
Good afternoon.
Mr. Sawa, what is government really doing?
I don't know what they're doing. You got to tell me what they're doing. I don't know. You got to tell me.
Mr. Sawa, is government going to kill everybody?
No. Can't say that. No, can't. No. The government not kill nobody. Call it. Can't see government kill people.
Good afternoon, Mr. Sharma.
Yes. Good afternoon.
Mr. Sharma.
Yes.
I have a complaint.
Yes.
This, dispensary here in social here.
Yes.
Every time you go to the locality itself, you got to make a donation.
But what part into it? Tell me what part into it, Joshin. What part of intuition? What part of intuition? What is the part of intuition?
You got to leave a donation because to help by
call, please understand me. What part of intuition? What part of intuition?
And if you don't leave it.
Oh, now it is now the black it. Yes, yes.
Black it, intuition.
Yeah, that's right.
And the point is that.
Yeah, yes.
You know, right now, things are that flowing like money, and that's flowing like
okay.
Before.
Yes.
Right? The government responsible for that, not the poor people who go to this.
How do you government respond for that? How do you government respond for that?
I didn't get you.
How come the government responds for that?
Now let me get you clear. Yeah. This here heading this government directly out of power. I'm telling you this, Mr. Sharma. That's not the easy government.
Yes.
But I'm telling you this.
Yes.
Right, this is taking the government out of office. I'm telling you, whether all these things going on, the government needs to send people to investigate what is going on around the area. Right?
Okay. Thank you very much. Call in here. Hello?
Good day, Mr. Sharma.
Good day. Yes.
Now, my point is
Yes.
Government did not tax
the
tuition. Yes. They taxed the school.
Yeah.
Who was not paying
taxes.
So, people must get it right.
Yes.
They taxed the school.
Yes.
Not the tuition.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Clarify.
I'm not so sure if it's so clarified.
Yeah. So I give a summary.
No, I'm not so sure. But I'm saying in some private schools, I know in the United States, there's an organization called Soka Gakkai International.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they have value systems that they incorporate where they teach, where they incorporate into the teaching values about life, you know, and so on. So I'm not in favor of it. If you're taxing the school, you're also putting a tax on these things, you know. You want more people to have values in life, to have principles that they act upon.
Well, I don't know about that. In our American schools, the term we would use is secularization. They have secularized the public schools, and that's why the Christian school movement, and then there's also private schools, Hindu and Muslim, that have risen up in the U.S., because it is valueless. You listen to me, friends. They're saying you choose what you want to choose. You can choose to be what you want to be.
Yes.
You can choose who you are. Today I might be this. Tomorrow I might be that. And so what I'm saying is some of the schools in some parts of America do not teach values. That's why private schools, accelerated education. Hey, what about kids with special needs?
Wonderful.
I mean, I know schools that are for all-girl schools that recruit young girls that have gone through hard
times
that you have spoken of. So I think the variety of education builds a great nation. It builds people where they are and builds them up.
And
so it's a real challenge for public education today. It's a real challenge. Pray for your schools.
Yeah. God, you need. Good afternoon,
good afternoon,
yes.
Firstly, I must correct this lady. The lady that is not because the son is 16 years, 9 months.
Yes.
You can't enter school at 16 years, 9 months.
Yes.
You could continue going to school.
I didn't know that.
On 16 years, 9 months.
Continue.
But you cannot enter school at 16 years.
For the first time.
Okay.
Is it the first time he's entering?
No.
The other thing is,
yes.
She doesn't respond when I call, right? The other thing is, that this decision that was made in the Court of Appeal concerning the third term president.
Yes.
Whereby the two judges say they're supposed to have a referendum to amend the constitution.
Yes.
Now if they have to have a referendum to amend that part of the constitution.
Yes.
Then every other amendment that they have made to that constitution is a whole Pandora box to open.
Yeah.
That every other amendment that they have made to that constitution is illegal. Yeah. Therefore, the president gonna have to appoint the chairman election commission all by himself without consultation with the opposition. The president will have to appoint the chief justice, the chancellor of judiciary, without input of the opposition.
Okay.
So all those things will become null and void anytime this single amendment is upheld.
Yes.
So I want the opposition to know that this is a Pandora box to open. They don't want to go down that road.
Okay. Thank you very much. Call in here. Hello.
Bundang.
We're going to turn now. Yes.
Concerning that education.
Yes.
Well, my son was at school, the Perico Secondary School. Some misunderstand with him and the teacher.
Yes.
They said that he must stay away from school. Well, the teacher told me that let him go to a new environment. Send him to a pay school. I was told that.
Yes.
But the child don't want to go to pay school. He said, Mama want to go to, they said, government school.
Yes.
Apparently, he's more comfortable with the cousin, because lots of cousins they're going. So when you send them to pay, they don't have much relative there. So children is special. We have to treat children special.
So,
they need an education. They are illiterate.
So,
we have these robbery, choke and rob, stealing going
on
because of education.
Yeah, Sikapin, couldn't he have gone to another government school?
No, they said, age catch up with him.
No, he is a continuing student.
He don't want to go to the pay school.
No, but couldn't he have continued? Is it secondary school?
No, he's at home all the time.
No, was he attending primary or secondary?
The secondary, pre-secondary. He
but
was
then,
a pupil there.
At age 17, you could still be taking exams.
Yeah. I don't know. They said, well, I went to ask Ed Brother.
And the Ministry of Education?
Yeah, they told me that he's too big.
Who told you that?
I was told that from the Ministry of Education.
Okay. Who was the minister at that time?
Well, I saw a woman there. I cannot remember her name.
Mm.
But what I'm saying, they are saying that he cannot go because he's 17.
So, you know what that?
He's 17.
I don't know what any restrictions.
And he don't
like
want
that.
To go to pay school.
Yeah.
Unless he did something very serious.
Nothing about this serious. But the age, I want to say age
serious?
Catch up. No, I'm there. Oh, yeah. Remember, I'm a committee worker.
Okay.
I was a PTA chairman twice.
Okay.
What age catch up with him because of age?
No, 17, you can still be taking your.
And they said
your levels. I mean, I know fellas who do
it. Wouldn't
you call that Sankey a transfer student?
What did I say?
He could be doing his 17.
I was told to send him to a technical institute.
Yeah.
But what I'm trying to tell my son, when you go to that institute to learn, you need to write. You must know to spell these things. So education is really important.
That's right.
Even if you keep them away, send them to institute,
what about
they have to know
college?
To read properly, they have to know
Quechua
to write.
Quechua Quechua they've got classes.
I don't know much about that.
Yeah, you should try that.
I don't know about
Mr. Lincoln Lewis is
used. But we in the country, Brigadier, we need things like technical institute. That is my, when I was a candidate for election, I make that proposal. I spoke to some people at Queen's College Kampong there. They said they want to do a course at Perico for children drop out. They are I want the public to know
what
this.
Happened to that?
They have the marketing center vacant. I'm speaking in the public here now.
Yeah.
I was told to see the REO to get that top of the marketing center where they used to keep these GCOM place.
Yeah.
We asked for that building for the children to go to school there.
Yes.
People from Queen's College Kampong said they want to teach children values.
You could have distance education.
Education. Things that they would do, such as cosmetology, air, you know, other courses they could do. And downstairs there is an office locked up. We need it for a welfare building.
Okay.
I'm asking the public there. They said to see the area, discussing with the regional chairman. He said that is no that problem. So the public appealing, that was my motive for my election campaign.
Yeah.
Why we have a problem in this country with the end is with the mayor, when Mr. Granger announces for election to the public, he said, please come out public and tell what is your proposal for the people. People did not tell the public what they would do for them. For my community, I must be the only one get a paper draft out, get the vending off the street at Perico. I went to Transport and Arbor, asked them to build a wharf.
Yeah.
They agreed to that.
Yeah.
I wrote Mr. Granger. I said, Mr. Granger, I went to transport and asked to get the vendors off the stelling because they are using the road, which is dangerous. And they are both going into and from the ferry. Yeah. So they are blockage if you all go to Pricknow. They have nowhere for the vendor. We need to do that.
Okay.
Transport said they would do it.
Mark,
but let's go back to
Mark
education.
Mark is somebody very, very good, vibrant speaker. Very, very good. But which school again?
Let's go back.
I do lots. I was a police. Yeah, I went lots of.
Okay. But let's go back to education. Yeah. Why don't they have it? Yeah. You spoke with the Queen's College compound. They have distance education being done there at the adult evening, adult classes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why can't they do something there?
They want to go to Perica. They say find a place.
No. You can have a place where you have where you can communicate and classes can be conducted in Perica.
Yeah.
And distance education. When you speak to your REO about
it. Well, not as yet. I'll do that. Okay. I plan to do that.
Yeah, coordinator. Hello?
Good afternoon, Mr. Sharp.
Yes.
And my fellow white brothers and sitting
here. Yes.
Wait a minute. Who's white?
White and black.
Are you talking about her?
I'm very sorry for that.
Yes.
Let me explain one thing to him.
Yes.
Is the Americans have this country running like this?
No.
Wrong.
I am telling you that.
No.
I'm telling you that. They remove a good government, place one that creates no good problem on the other.
Well, that is your view.
Tell me his statement again. What did he say?
Call you in here. Hello?
They remove. Yeah. The people remove. Who is
the
even they remove? Yeah.
American comment do not.
The people had elections.
They make the choice.
They made a choice.
Not if people got illiterate in this country. Not illiterate people got in this country.
I got 10 years visa to go.
If you're blaming me, I'm getting too much credit.
Yes.
No. I'm proud of you. Yes. I'm proud of you.
If you're blaming me, there's too much credit.
Hello? But you look pink.
Yes.
Yes. Hear what one body says.
Yes.
It's all a pleasure. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
The lady there and the other two brothers, Mr. Sandy and the other brother.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Please let me keep it, normal, right?
Yes.
Now, I overheard the lady talking about the schooling and the government talking about private schooling.
Yes.
Mr. Sharma, look, let me face reality. And I don't like when you ask for evidence when you know the truth. It is wrong. Let me you're a part of this coalition. I is one who worked feverous on
time. I worked too.
On when the, even though when you was in turmoil.
Yes.
People worked remove you from the stigma and all these things. And we must, God, we find
forward.
And don't let the people interrupt when you see the talking about that government or this government.
Yes.
A true shepherd.
Yes.
Don't have to start for the sheep.
Yeah.
The sheep will follow. And if you have shepherds who don't know the shepherd's sheep, they have to go.
Yes.
It is simple as that. Now you're going to tell me, let me be real secure.
Yes.
No, you're going to tell me. The fat cats won't feel the heat.
Yes.
And it is better there.
Yes.
You all won't feel the heat because you all have worked from before and put up the little that you all had.
Yes.
So you could have something sustainable.
Yes.
It's like a child on his mother's breast.
Yes.
Don't know the child on the mother's breast and looking after the mother eat before she could get baby breastfed.
Okay.
But he's looking for breastfed. Okay.
Yes.
Isn't it so?
Yeah, that's
now, true. let me be realistic. Yes. No, Mr. Sankey and the other brother, also Mr. Sharma.
Yes.
So you went to private school in your time.
Yes, I went to private school, yes.
You get the point?
Yes.
I went to public school.
I went to public school.
I went to public school.
Good. Okay. Now, I'm saying to the government, the competition between the private school and the government school, you find the teachers, the qualified ones, who didn't get the opportunity to go away, they open private school.
Yes.
So what happened?
Yes.
The poor man got to find the money for sending children, even though they fed the idea of the government school.
Yes.
They're not interested in the loan or not. Because when the day finishes, they got them to carry them to the private school.
Yes.
For sure, when they will start doing something there.
Yes.
And I believe it is unfair.
Yes.
And anyhow, generally,
yes.
I don't believe the school system, because when the tax comes down, it's coming back to the small man.
Small man,
yes. Because it's how you say it's coming back to the smart man.
Yes.
And this statement we know that we know that the God is alive and well. When we're going to hear the Honorable Mr. Wu saying that, you know what, we're going to keep a crusade because the country has got money. Wait, you take me God, my fucking stuff. It is wrong.
Yes.
It is wrong. Yeah. Before you keep a crusade okay. and then you go yeah. down looking okay. for taxes in all the areas okay. and you want the yes. people to offer in okay, the other okay, area. Okay. So when you don't leave the salary that you have, or three quarter put back the 50% yeah. salary, yeah. that you could use that instead of teaching yeah. crusade and people could throw their little, you know, shingling,
yes.
you could take your half and use yes. all the ministers and put yeah. it there, you will yeah. have four trucks more than what you have to get.
Man.
So it is wrong, you're bleeding the people. Okay.
Thank you, Aaron.
So, hold on. Yeah. Hold on, Mr.
Yes, yes. 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 Yes.
Now, you talk, talking about.
Yes. Yes.
This song.
Yeah.
What is his name there? This place that Coleman John, great president, born up.
Yes.
The only man was a president with a vision yeah. in yes. country is Lyndon Farr, born up.
Yes.
The rest is pure black people. See what I'm telling you?
Yes. No. Yes. Why you say they're blind? Why you say they're blind?
Huh?
Why you say they're blind?
Anybody got good sight that will see, get a vision for seeing the lead the people. You can't lead the people and you want somebody to lead you. It's like two blind men.
Okay, go ahead.
No, look.
Yes.
You got this place yeah, a yeah. delinquent home there.
Yes, yes.
I don't like the name. Now, you could remember that place they had born. Nobody does like your school is used to name delinquent
home. Yes, I know, I remember that, yes.
Good.
Yes.
No, you got, they're yes. doing some things there for yes. the elderly yes, people, yes. or yes. big women, yes. we must call them.
Yes.
And where do you think they put it? Now that they're, it's so embarrassing. I never see a battered up woman in this country.
Yes.
You got it now, home for battered up women.
Okay.
Why, you know, and then you're talking about respecting women. Which woman you look, you could walk on the road and tell me she battered up? This thing, you know, okay. I don't understand.
Okay.
And I believe we need to change the Constitution. And if the Constitution cannot change by getting the support yeah. of the opposition,
yes.
by force,
yes.
But everybody going and enjoy the Constitution.
Yeah, that's true.
So that they're going to change yeah. the Constitution, yeah. and I've seen anything so far. So we are coming and inherit the sweet and the taxpayer feeling it, and the small man yes. is dropping out. Yes. So what's going on, man?
Yes.
And let me face reality. I understand. I saw the brother came on TV from Hope there and said that he inherited Hope in a mess. I don't know if you see that.
Yes.
I is the one, you know, when I call you after asking about the land and open, I fight them for the
open. Oh, yes, yes, right, yes, that's right, that's right, yes, 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 yes.
We take things from the shop, from people's shop,
yes, yes.
and repair open. The yes. office we they need, don't know it's everything.
Okay.
That people do is power, so the people have to, we have to find money and fight, what we can find, we have to fetch the back.
Okay.
And give the people, until now. Balmukun and get a cent for yeah. joining the hope. And this is why I'm saying you got to hold up and all of them from the AFC. And you got this other, the same one, working in the Abokis, the liar for Nari, from PPP. Now you bet a man from the PPP from Tillard West Coast.
Yeah.
Put him in the office. He knows nothing and talk about people give away. We put on a big red gate there for keep all the animal them from killing them people children in hope. The one see there is cards, you know what it cards?
Yeah.
Nobody pay me for it. Then we went to down there, they come and they got a school in there with some small children.
Yes.
Think it's two things we do in hope and we have to fight money until now people ask me for their money.
Okay.
You see? And the brother never gets a salary. They didn't give you a salary.
Okay.
The C-person is the man I'm talking about. He's in the Nari. I talk it. I even want to reach him.
Okay.
And he faced this man and they face something like me on
yes.
the talk, but
yes.
he could reach open up for
upstate. Yeah.
They're thieving the money. Got yeah. home from this back the body and put himself in the position. Yeah. They didn't have a function manager because yeah. when Baruch was all out the belly yeah. and we need trouble from this country, the father vehicle, from there we break down gasoline.
Okay.
I already want to know you're going, you're trying to influence.
So what bank job? What bank job you really know?
The brother got a job.
Yeah, yes.
You think it is fair and yes, so for our creeds? It isn't fair.
Yes.
And then they feel coming for tax to them. You know, yes. they're so sad. Yes. They're like, when yes. they're like the kind of candles yes. in the yes. last white light them,
yes.
and they bend for one side and all the waxes yes. dropping off yes. on the other side.
Yes.
I see that, you know, these people must be realistic.
Yes.
You cannot run this country, this small country without
okay. Call it, thank you very
and you almost stop talking about. Yes. America.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Getting American money.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, man.
Talk a lot, Gladys. You know, Gladys, sensible thing you say.
Yeah, he talks.
Call in. Hello?
Mr. Sharma, I want to congratulate that lady.
Yes.
Tell her to continue
yes.
the good work that
yes.
she's
moreover, I want to congratulate Mr. I remember Burnham used to give children free books.
Yes.
It is kind of hard for poor people to pay all those tax in the book.
Okay.
It's not right.
Okay.
You know, the Chinese people, you have a lot of poor people. Some of them are illiterate.
Okay, sure. I know that they're illiterate. Plenty of illiterate people are in this country.
In America, they have older people that go to school and get a diploma.
Reading programs. Yes. Yes.
Older children to go back and learn. I don't see nothing wrong with that. You know, I don't know what's wrong with the Chinese society. I think they've gone crazy. The former
governor, ma'am, of the state of North Carolina, Democrat friend of mine, James Hunt, he initiated, not by words but by action, an after-school reading program where he would go once a week and he would read to children. And I don't like to put adjectives in front of children. I don't like to say short children, fat children, white children, black children.
Discrimination.
He would go to children that face great tough times in urban centers. And what you've said is a great point. It was a volunteer reading program, and it was beautiful. So thanks for calling in and sharing that insight. Because San Key, psychologically, the ability to read and the work of the mind when you read and understand letters, powerful.
Yeah, make a point.
To my fellow American, to my right, I must say I'm proud of you here. With Mr. Sharma, he's a great man.
Absolutely.
And I want to be on your program with other issue, family issue, as a social worker.
I welcome you.
My message in Essequibo, please, I want to bring up my grandchildren. Because my dad was very strict. We grew up, they said, Labo come out of all. Because we didn't know about these things now. They used to laugh us because my dad was strict. And we need the old people. They are saying that old people step down. But we want you all to keep stepping up to mold us, the youths.
They have the wisdom.
The elderly have the wisdom, not the young
mentorship,
people.
Mentorship.
And my fellow, I received 10 years ago to your state. And I'm coming to see you.
Okay.
Yeah, you're a great man. Yes.
So you got your visa.
Yes, I got my
visa. All right,
visa.
Well, look, here's someone on air. She's got her visa.
How about that?
See, you weren't blocked out by the new president.
No,
how about that?
I do project with the ambassador.
Wonderful. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Have a nice day. God bless you, right?
Yeah, and in Essequibo I'm coming for my grand.
Okay. Wait a minute. Let me tell you this. When you come to America, I'll be in Guyana.
All right. Thank you. God bless everybody.
Bye-bye.
Very good point, though. Very good point was brought up by her concerning education. Distance education. And we need to push more distance education in the region. She spoke about Perica, identifying a building where people can go and adults and children who got left out of the system, they can go and have and educate themselves without coming to Georgetown.
We have Minister Jayapal to begin the program next couple of minutes from now. Call you here. Hello?
Hi, Mr. Shamo.
Yes.
I'd like to tell the lady earlier before we said that the government matching up the schools with these taxes. I like to ask the lady if she can remember, because at that age, we had free education from Northwick University in Bottom Town. When Barajabio come in, he matched up the education system, he sent them come in and invest money in the private school. So, when she started to massacre, and another thing, Mr. Jaipal, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
Now it depends on how to investigate James things. Check Mogotani healing and talk to Mogotani. Now it depends to investigate James things. Now it depends to investigate.
You have a reason for saying this? You have a reason for saying this, sir?
Call it here. Go ahead, please. Hello?
Turn down.
We're going to take them up because we can. Call it here. Hello? Hello? Hello, caller in the ear. Hello?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes. Good afternoon.
All the promises that we
did
from this government.
I'm not hearing you.
Can you speak louder? Speak up, speak up.
Well, all the promises that this government made where any election was on.
Yeah.
It never fulfilled none.
All why you say that? Why do you say that? Why do you say that? No, 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 no. No, 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 it can't fulfill right now.
Let him name the promises.
No, no.
Yeah.
If
it's
protest with the
media,
yeah.
I think it's better for the people in protest to get this government out. This government,
no, no.
Is
it's not a government problem. It's a council problem.
That's the city council.
City council problem. He's attacking, he attack anything, right?
Yeah, he just
call the call in. You just call in here, call in here. Hello?
Yes,
yeah.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, yes. Oh, yes, yes.
Honorable Minister,
yes, yes.
And the panel.
Yes.
Now, my take on this,
yes,
taking the VAT, yes, on the private schools.
Yes.
Now, the good book says, render to Caesar the laws of Caesar and to God the laws that are God.
Yeah.
Now, the law in the revenue states,
yes,
that after earning so much, having so much of millions per year, you are required to pay tax.
Yes.
Now, because of this tax, people are going to get to know what was really undercover. Because coals are supposed to be registered with the, yes, DRA. Majority have not been registered.
Yes.
And the private school, the owners of the private school, are putting the teachers, yes, that they must pay, yes, their own tax and their own, okay, NIS in the contract. Now, if the law of the land stipulates, after having, yes, so much a million,
yes,
you ought to pay tax, they, yes, are receiving exorbitant prices for the private school. Yes. Why can't they pay back to, yes, pay back, yes, to the government? Yes. It's not the the burden is, yes, on the parents. Yes. The burden is on, yes, the school. Yes.
They have an income tax.
And, yes, they need to come up to the law of the land. So many things was happening in 23 years.
Yes.
Now things are being opened.
That's right. That's right. That's
they
right.
Are,
yes,
being now seen,
yes,
because,
yes, yes,
we the parents need, yes, to take time, yes, up and listen, yes, to what, yes, is being said and take, yes, cognizance, yes, of the fact, yes, how the private school are,
okay,
so wrong.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let me take some more calls before we talk to the minister. Call in. Call in here. Hello? Call in here. Call you in here. Hello? Yeah.
Yeah. We're sorry. This number is temporarily disabled.
Call you in here. Go ahead, please.
Turn down.
Yeah. Jaipal?
No, I must say,
yes,
we should take more calls,
yes,
because that caller,
yeah,
and many,
yeah,
other callers,
yes,
are very educated,
yeah, yes,
about what is,
yeah,
going on in the country.
Yeah.
As that caller rightfully pointed,
yeah,
out, is what is going on in the private school, in terms that we only recently discovered, you know, heard from the Minister of Finance himself, that only 57% of the private schools in this country is registered with GRA.
Wow.
That is only,
wow,
54 schools in total.
Mm.
That represents 57% of the schools, private schools, only registered with GRE. Of that amount, it's alarming that 8 of those 54 schools, 8 of them are collecting $2 billion a year from you, the ordinary people, for tuition fees. These fees are sometimes more than what students pay at University of Guyana. So why are Guyanese people punishing themselves so much to finance these schools? Now, a previous caller said something important too. The former president and now leader of the opposition, Dr. Barjack Diop, had made a statement on his press conference, his leader of the opposition press conference on Monday. On the various Mondays, they have these press conference. What he said is that under his administration, private schools sprung up. And he's accrediting this private school springing up all over the place, right, as being good for his government. But a caller rightfully say that's an indictment on his government because of that previous administration destruction of the public education school system allow private schools to spring up.
Unregulated.
Okay? So it's not something he should be congratulating himself about, but it's an indictment of his government that he give the private school the opportunity to create an industry in Guyana. So he basically, as the caller alluded to, maybe it's a conspiracy that he did not focus, Jack Dio and the PPC did not focus on public education, making it better. So the poor people of this country would not have to go into the arms of the private school to educate themselves. Why you go to private school? What is some of the reason why? Because you believe they're being better teachers. Where the teachers came from? You think the teachers came from US or Canada or Europe? The teachers are Guyanese teachers that we, the government, financed to train, educate. And these private schools took them over from the public education school system. So the teachers didn't arrive from thin air. They were trained with taxpayers' money. These private schools now offer them a 10,000 more. If you want the teachers of this country to receive a better salary, if the government asks you, the parents, to donate maybe $1,000 each month so it could subsidize the teacher's salary, so the teachers don't have to gravitate to private schools. You have to understand, when government put the VAT in education, it's not like they want to prevent people from learning educated, but what they want is to widen the tax base. And in widening tax base, we cannot do that in a haphazard manner. We cannot say, oh, certain schools must pay and certain schools must not pay. You must have equality. Everyone must pay. So you have equality.
Okay.
But in having that equality, what the tax money, what that VAT money will go to? It will go to what? Build schools. So when government say VAT on private education, tuition fees, what government would use that money for? Create more public schools. Not just private education. The money that we collected on private education, what do you think it is, the VAT? It's 350 million Guyan dollars estimated a year. That can't do anything, really. But it's VAT in its entirety, and other taxes will go to build more schools. So when government going to say there's VAT on private education, parents now should say, if you're reasonable, common sense will say, I can't afford it, I will have to put my children in private school. Sorry, take them out of private school, put them in the public school.
Yeah.
What government? Government now forcing themselves. Government putting themselves under more pressure to build more schools because there will be a demand for public education. Same thing with the health sector. When government say there's VAT on health care for private health care providers, government is forced now to spend more money for public hospitals. So this government is not like the previous government that gave the responsibility to the private sector to provide education and health care. But we want the responsibility. So we are financing more schools from taxpayers' money, from borrowings, because we want to give you free education and free health care. Not like the previous government. So you see, you listen to the leading opposition in the PPP, and because few poor people are suffering, you must make the exception. The PPP always, and the rich people of this country, always use the poor to get off. What the Minister of Finance say is, instead of the few poor people who are going to private schools cry out, and the rich people saying, hey, the poor people are punishing, let us remove the VAT, the 40% VAT. What the Minister of Finance is saying, and what you don't know, is that 26% of the 54 schools was already paying and charging VAT on education. Was already charging VAT in education. That didn't affect no one. But suddenly, so everybody have to pay VAT now in education. It's affecting people.
Okay.
So what the minister is basically saying is that these private educators, these private schools, they could say, okay, if you are poor, put some means test. Okay. And what they could do, they now could say, you don't have to pay no VAT. So if there are 10 persons, 10 parents in this private school that are poor, and for some reason they want the children to go to private schools, we're not saying don't send your children to private school, but that private school have the opportunity to say to those parents, you don't need to pay VAT on it any longer because we're going to do a tax write-off. So if they say no tax for 10 parents, they apply to the GRA that they give tax write-off. And they don't have to pay. It comes out of that money.
Okay.
So, they see they're using the few poor people in the private school system to say everyone must not pay. Okay. And that is wrong.
Okay. Call your name. Hello? Hello, call your name. Hello? Call your name. Call your name. Hello?
Hello. morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Good afternoon.
Yeah,
I
good
don't know if I can raise a social issue, right?
Yeah.
It's
in
the Bel Air.
Yes.
Lillendal area.
Yes.
Actually, residents had made reports many times to the police, but no action has been taken.
Who the resident?
There's a very old Rasta man
living
in, I think, Third Street, Lillendal.
Yes.
His name is Mr. Pablo.
Yes.
I don't know if I should call his
name. No, don't call his name.
But
He's
around the neighborhood.
Yeah.
For many years now, maybe 10, 15 years, he's looking for very vulnerable people, and he's trying to get money from them.
Okay.
And as soon as he gets the money, he's going to buy...
How you know that?
Right?
And how you know that? How do you know that?
Well, so people are saying, if you have to ask, if you're going to investigate, somebody's going to investigate who's hearing this,
okay.
You can follow up that, right?
Okay.
But then, the issue is that he's very old now.
Yeah.
And it's very problematic dealing with him. I don't know if the social minister, if she got community, could assist that he could go in a poor people's home with somebody to take care of him, you know?
Okay.
Okay, all right.
Thank you very much. He's a pandit, I know him. He didn't recognize his voice.
Not a bandit.
Good afternoon.
Guy Paul.
Yes.
Well, why the government raise the alimony 100%? And the poor people, them ain't got nothing, but y'all get 100%. All the ministers getting almost million. He could see that kind of bad. But the poor people could pay? Answer that question.
Well, look, this thing about government ministers getting 100% is not true. And we explained to you over and over the reason why. The last increase paid to public servant, ministers didn't receive it. Public servants receive a 54% increase in their wages and salaries since this government came into office, less than 2 years. That is breaking records throughout the Caribbean and maybe the world. So, in 18 months, 54% increased minimum wage for public servants. Imagine that. No administration would do that. Because of the expectation that people had when a new government came in, this is what they wanted. And so when government did a review of the salaries of ministers previously, they realized that it cannot work for their ministers. Why it can't work? Because we have a hierarchy of ministers starting from ministers within, like myself, then we have senior ministers, then we have vice president, and then we have prime ministers, and so forth. But the previous government could easily say, no vice president, they don't want vice president. The previous government never had a vice president. Okay? So they had junior ministers, senior ministers, and paying them both the same salary. You don't think that's a recipe for corruption?
Yeah.
So ask the senior ministers and junior ministers how they top up the salary by underhand deals. And the forensic audit is picking up that. We want that. We don't want that level of corruption. So you pay everyone a salary. Maybe government will not increase salaries for ministers until the next elections when we get back in office. So you stabilize it, and basically that is what they did at the commencement of it. Stabilize the salary of the ministers and the hierarchy. Because you have to understand, the president of this country don't want his minister in underhand deals and what's not like that. So we did not, although we gave a second increase, we did not increase our salary. There's a third increase. It have to be discussed with the unions. Again, ministers may or may not receive that salary again, that increase in salary. So this argument, what you put in, is only propaganda from the opposition.
Okay,
so the forensic audit is saying, and it's going to be pointing how ministers subsidize, the previous government subsidized their salaries.
Okay, Mark, what summary is your view with the minister?
Well, I think he made a great point when he talked about when you look at why this is being done, where is it going? It's going to build education. It's going to build health care. So let the voice of the people speak and hold them accountable and see it continue to grow for the betterment of the children, for the betterment, because we know new schools have to be built. You got to step up. We can't educate people today like we did 40 years ago. So this issue that he is well spoken of, and I agree with you, those previous callers had excellent responses from different ways. And the scripture verse that many of you heard, render unto Caesar what is Caesar's, render unto God what is God's. Well, here for education and health, this will only do it to make it better, to improve it and face the challenges of the 21st century.
When I said the previous government did not have vice president, they didn't announce a vice president in the hierarchy, but they had advisors to the president. So Gail Teixeira was an advisor to the president. She wasn't a vice president, but she was an advisor, and her salary was over $1 million as an advisor to the president, but not vice president.
Lumumba
Gain was the next, and they had so many persons that they were paying huge sums of money. But we want to be a transparent government, and we say no more advisors, but you will be vice president.
Concerning the education, Courtney, we spoke of more schools, but I think also the quality.
Good afternoon to you, Mr. Shawa.
Yes.
And your high-powered panel this afternoon.
Yes.
Representing from the U.S. government.
Yes.
And Mr. Sharma.
Yes.
Minister.
Yes.
So we were hearing about this, audits and audits.
Yes.
And last week in the press.
Yes.
That the Minister of Home Affairs saying that you would charge ministers and put them in front of the government.
Yes.
I put them in front of the court.
Yes.
I haven't seen that man. You wait for that thing there long. They charge them by and see what happened.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All these things are games.
Yes.
They got to stop playing games with the people.
It's not a game.
And I come straight to the people.
It's not a game. Let me just address the
issue. Okay.
It's going at 250 to 16 right now.
Yeah.
You're 14%. That you dropped this drastic.
Yes.
14%. Got 20% in my calculation. I didn't go to school too far.
Yeah.
But in my calculation, it's about 20% right now.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All the merchants buy as against the US dollar.
Yes.
And they have to pay $250 or $216. Work it out, Mr. Sharma, because you are your counter.
Okay. Thank you very much.
It goes to 20.
Yeah.
And the VAT is now 20-25%.
Okay. Thank you.
Across the board for the people.
Okay.
What is going to happen?
Okay.
You have to start telling the people differently, because in a few months from now, when the US, and I know it's going to go up, if you don't do something different.
Okay, thank you very much.
And then, what are you going to fool the people with again?
Okay.
You have to stop this thing about the government, the past, but start to do things different.
Okay, thank you very
much. Make the people understand this is what the economy is.
Okay, thank you.
Don't fool the people all the time.
Okay, thank you.
I don't know what game he's speaking about. The vice president and minister responsible for public security said to the media that two foreign ministers will be charged. And he can't press the charges. He's the government minister. The legal system has to work. It has to go through the police legal advisor, the DPP. So he probably have a report saying that it's recommended to be charged, and he pronouncing that. But the individual, which is the police legal advisor, was on the team of the three panel members who had to select the acting Chief Justice and Chancellor of the country. So the police legal advisor could not work on those matters to charge the two previous ministers that Minister Cameron Ramzan spoke about. So they're not befooling you. They will be charged if the police legal advisor, the DPP, agree with what was recommended by the Special Organized Crime Unit. So understand, it's a process. So we didn't fool you. Maybe the minister jumped the gun and he reported to the media that ministers will be charged. But we did not want to create a position which you're accusing us that we want to distract from whatever is going on in the country. Okay, you made a very important point that the U.S. The Guyana rate is increasing. It's not government, it's market forces. And if the economy is doing poorly, why the business people demanding U.S. dollars?
Yeah.
So what they're doing with it? So answer yourself. If the economy is not moving and is stagnant and is sluggish, why there's so much demand for U.S. dollars, carrying up the U.S.? So it's part of the economic sabotage. I continue to say to you, it's being perpetrated in the country.
Colony, okay. Colony, hello?
Hello, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Can the Honorable Minister clarify this 54% increase in this government of office?
Okay.
Please let me explain how that the amount came about.
Okay, public, thank you.
Public service?
Yeah. Okay, we are going to, we're going to discuss this the next program.
Yes.
Because I will have to tell you, look, when we came into office, the minimum wage the public public servants was in the vicinity of, say, about 40,000. We move it automatically from 40 to 50. Check the increase there. So we didn't say, look, you're going to get a 5%. We said everybody from now going to get 50,000. Okay? Now you look at that position we did in 2015 and look what is the minimum wage today of 55,000. But then look at the tax threshold. So indirectly, although you didn't give a large amount to increase, the tax threshold gave you more money in your pocket. So, like the former president, Jack Liu, he increased his salary to what? Over the period. Hundreds of percent, 500%. But at a point in time, Jack Liu said his salary shall be non-taxable. Just by making his salary non-taxable, he automatically gave himself a further 300% increase.
Mm-hmm.
Because no longer he was subject to the tax at one third. So you have to understand these things. And the former president Jack Liu was playing games with you. Did he play in a saint now and saying, I will not take my salary as leader of the opposition? And he said to the people, I won't take the salary of leader of the opposition. So you believe he's working free as leader of the opposition. But he's collected a pension of $1.4 million tax-free. So if he had collected that salary, he would be taken home less. See, he's not a saint. He's very wise.
Call
but
he's
not telling you the truth.
Hello, call your neighbor. Hello?
Good afternoon, Mr. Shah.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mr. Minister.
Yes.
So when you talk about education, right, we agree with what you're saying, but if you go to most of the government schools, you know, that these teachers are not paying attention to these children, and that could be a cause to make people to take their children out of government schools.
Carla, please take a point. Right. Correct. We recognize that these are issues, and that is the reason why we're going to have a reform of the government system, public education school system. The teacher will be properly trained and everything. So what I'm saying, you have a choice. Carry your children to the private school, but the private school could say to you, if you say you're poor, they could say you don't have to pay the 14%. So why would they want you not to pay the 14%? All we have to say in their books that Tom Jones and Harry and James, the earnings is below 100,000, they can't afford it, and therefore the school will say you will not be paying the VAT. And they will say to the GRE that I give 10 or 20 persons this write-off, and you will take it off, we, the government, will take it off from the money that the private school have to pay.
Call
so if you want to continue to send your children to private school, go ahead. Yes. Remember, I could tell you, a private school in primary education, secondary education. You want to match them with a public school like Queen's College or one of the top primary school? They can't match. It's only recent the Swami school top the country. Guyana and the whole top the entire Caribbean. Okay, so it has to be something good.
Sir, give us our review about the education.
No, well, Jaipur mentioned that they're going to use the money to build more schools, but also the quality of teachers, you have to pay them. You have to trap them.
No, well, that is what we're doing.
Yeah, that's what I'm
teachers,
saying.
For the first time, the previous government promised teachers two things. They said they will have a revolving fund for the teachers to get affordable housing. Never happened. Although the parliament then, with the consent of the opposition then, told the previous government, gave the teacher the money, they got that money and put it in an account, never use it to give the teacher. They promised the teachers duty-free vehicles, never. We said only recently teachers will have the duty-free vehicles and they will have affordable housing. So these are benefits added to your salary, will give you, the teachers, that comfortable life that they don't have to think about where they're going to get the additional dollars to pay the rent or to pay public transportation, things like that. They will have their own vehicle.
No parking meters.
And of course, no parking meters for teachers
for
or
a
school.
Teacher?
Oh, the school.
I'm going back to education.
Hello?
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Yes. Yes.
So, Minister, I want to publicly applaud this government for what
they are doing in a short space of time. They are doing well. But I would like to know if the government really has anything in place concerning this 14% reduction in VAT to police this reduction so that citizens can really benefit from this reduction, because with the 16%, I learned that many businesses were collecting the VAT and not paying up to the revenue authority. So I want to know if there is any system in place for us to really enjoy this 40% reduction.
Chaplain, can you address that?
2% reduction.
Well, again, is the propaganda of the opposition. Their VAT was reduced from 16 to 14%. Okay? Since there is a reduction, but at the same time, there's an expansion in the base. So, what I'm trying to say to you, the caller did allude to the private sector not paying over their fair share of VAT. Look at the example with the school. Government gave private school last year $150 million refund. I'm sure the parents did not know that. Okay? So, basically, what is happening? Let us take it, let's make it very simple. Now there is VAT now on building material. So, Mrs. C.N. Sharma, the building we sit in and have a three-story building. Now, again, I'm going to show you how the PPP government used the poor to benefit the rich. So, under the previous administration, there was no VAT on building material, it was zero rated. Now, zero rated means that the private business or business as a whole will get the refund from the government. So once something is zero rated, if the private business sell you, they go back and say to the government, we want back the money. So basically, government was subsidizing that private business. So Mr. C.N. Sharma have this three-story building. Say he's building it today. He will have to pay VAT and the material to build this building. For build a building this size, the VAT might be about $2 million for building material. It means when C.N. had paid, build this building, he didn't pay $2 million. He gets off at $2 million. If you build the same building today, you will have to pay $2 million more. Now you, the small man, you want to build a building. You're going to build a small building. Your VAT will be $200,000. What is the argument is that for that poor man to save him that $200,000, I must zero rate everything. So CN now will benefit from $2 million while I saving you $200,000. You pay your $200,000, let CN and business people like CN who build in these buildings pay the $2 million and $10 million and whatever. And so the money will come into a pool, so we could now distribute that money to pay what? Public assistance, more public assistance. People that cannot work for some reason, the other ill health, injuries or things like that. Old age pension. We could build a road in the community that is have poverty. We could have programs for children that are dropouts. So that is how VAT and taxes will help the poor. Not to say, for don't let that poor man or policewoman or nurse not pay the 40% VAT. I'm going to zero rate it. That poor person, and when you look at the variation in benefits, will be far less than what the rich are enjoying. So they always use the poor to justify the argument. And you yourself, the caller, has fallen in for that trap. So I explain to you a simple example. If you're going to build a home, yes, you have to pay VAT. You're going to pay $200,000 in your building material. A rich man who building a mansion like Jack Leo, he will have to pay $10 million for his building material. So when I help you for $200,000, Jack Leo get off with $10 million, and them like Jack Leo's get off with more. So don't let the exception be the reason why you're going to force the government to do something which you know is right for you.
Cardini, hello.
Hello, good afternoon again.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Honorable Minister State.
Yeah.
If this is the first time that teachers have granted to the free concession, thank you.
This is the first time the previous government who offered that to them, remember it had an expansion. So yes, they would have had, teachers would have had, but there's an expansion here. Teachers would have had, but not the category of teachers that was agreed to by the previous administration. This administration make it possible. Yes, it's the first time. So it all depends on the perspective, which way you see it. You want an argument. You want a debate.
Yeah, caught in here. Hello?
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I saw in the papers they raised the NIS pension money, $2,500 more a month. But when the pensioner goes and collect the book, they didn't get any refund for the year.
How you know that?
It is in the papers.
Is it that in the paper?
Raise it from what date did they raise it from?
I can't say what date, but the same year they got it. They raised the pension from 25, the book getting 25,000. He'll get 27,500 now.
Starting from when? What date?
January.
Well, you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Something to look into, so can't address every issue.
I have
so
an issue, that's right.
Your complaint will be noted and follow up.
Call in here. Hello, call in here.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
There's a quote that says that
yes.
If you think education is expensive, try ignorance.
Yeah.
And I think some people need to focus on that part. That is why so many of the young and the young poor orphan black guys are finding themselves before the court. Because of poor education, the parents don't want to spend the money on education before they take it by fun, clothes, go drink rum, go to all the different parties and sports.
Yes.
Now that we have to put a little extra for the children's education, everybody's crying out and going on.
Yeah.
I think the heaven and earth is coming down upon them.
Okay.
But Mr. Shamu, Chinese people have got to wake up.
Yes.
Caller, please stick a pin. I hope you're not you're going to side with the propaganda again. If you go into private school and you claim that you are poor, you can't afford it, go to the principal of that private school. Say to them, walk with your payslip. Say to them, this is my salary. I can't afford it.
Yeah.
That private school is going to say, you don't have to pay. Okay?
Okay.
Good.
Okay. Another thing before you go up to Mr. Sharma. Minister Sharma, I'd just like to say this to you. You know, one of the downfalls I have realized of this administration is that their PR system is very poor. Now, look, come Monday, Mr. Jack, you're going to be having a press conference. You're going to be talking and talking and saying that. But from the government perspective, there is nobody that comes on the air to rebut this guy and to put this guy in his place. And I think the PR
administration
needs to be stressed. Unless that is strengthened, unless it is strengthened, there will be all these perceptions and all these things people will be saying because you are not getting enough information coming out from the government. So I think y'all need to look at
the community. Thank you very much.
And I think more ministers need to come on program like this and to defend their ministry and their position. And look, I only found out because after we discussing the protests by the private school and so on, their position, I only recently found out that a head teacher from one of these private schools is declaring that their income is $80,000 a month.
Okay.
So, what they pay the teacher if it's 80,000 a month? We don't pay our grade 8 teachers 80,000 a month. So, how a head teacher from a private school get 80,000 a month? But this head teacher have a Mercedes Benz and two houses with swimming pool. So, you know, so they open a can of worms when they went to protest. We didn't want to say we're going to go after them, but we said, okay, if they're crying out so much, let's just see what they're earning. So when we look at the $2 billion they're raking in only 8 schools, you can imagine this industry.
Yes, yes.
So this is better than Kaisuku by 1,000 times.
Yes. More information needs to be given out from the government on these matters.
Yes. All right. Okay. Thank you very much. Cardiani here. Hello.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yes. Good night.
Yes. Yes.
Hello, good afternoon.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. Yes.
I'd like to call out and find out why government school is better than private school.
Yeah. Thank you. Go ahead.
No, we could have a debate on that, and I don't think we could debate that. But I'm saying to you, we could have debates on that. We could let the school children themselves debate it. A private school against a public school. Why you think public education is better? And you're more wronged in a public education school system. So it's far better. So I don't want to debate it. We don't have time. We have 10 minutes more. But I'm saying that let the public private school have a debate amongst themselves in relation to those issues.
Pastor Mark, what is it?
Proof, the proof is always in the product, isn't it? You know, what comes out, and that's a great idea. Put the kids up here and see where they're learning. The need of private schools, or the opportunity that came, as you had mentioned, for private education to rise up, in the history of it, from America, around the world, it's to specify specific education toward the child's gifts and needs. I had public education, so I got a well-rounded exposure to a lot of things and had choices with what they called elective classes. In a lot of the American private schools right now, one trend is they call them the Montessori schools, where they're accelerated education. Some of these kids will get out before they're 18 years old with a high school diploma. The proof is in the product. And so if you have special needs kids or you have high intellectual kids, let's see where it falls. I mean, young people that have a drive and have parents that are encouraging them to have a drive to reach goals and to learn, they can do well in about any situation. They can do well. So what do I think? The proof is in the product.
No, but I want to add further. You I think you hit the nail on its head.
Tell me what I just hit.
What? You just put in a nutshell the reason why our public education system is poor. And you didn't realize it. Because when you look at the results for CSEC and so on, what you will find is a few people topping the entire Caribbean.
Yeah.
Guyanese. And they write in something like 17, 20 subjects. So it put pressure in the educational system for the school or that class to focus on that particular few students to make them accelerated at that level. When the private school's system, the parent should take that child out from that environment, put them into a private school, or the state will have a special school for gifted students, so the teachers could focus on the weaker ones.
Yeah.
So that is the reason why our system is so poor, because we're doing too many subjects in the classroom. So we need to focus on the STEM subjects, limited the number of subjects, maybe maximum. And so those students that want to do 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 subjects, these are gifted students. Okay. They should not be in the public education system, or the public education system should identify them and put them in a special school, or private sector schools, private schools should cater for these students. That is the reason for the weakness in the public education system.
Jeffrey Sankey, your closing remarks.
Well, Sian, I think we focused a lot on education today. I think the lady, Ms. Carter, who was here,
brought
up some good points here where we need to deal with school dropouts, and we need to have a system in the regions where you can have distance education, you know, at affordable level, maybe at no cost or low cost, and, you know, implemented. I don't know what its existing system right now, but all the regions, and she spoke of Parika region, needs one, you know, and we need to have that implemented. Now, I think Jaipur mentioned that we need the money used from the taxes and so on to help to build more schools, and also we hope that there will be the quality of teachers will be there, they'll be paid better, and the value system too will improve in terms of values people can learn in the public system too, because that is what I think is important in the private schools, that I think the Swami who has a school, the cultural values, I think that are being inculcated, but they are very important, you know, in life, you know, that you should have a value system in life.
Minister, closing remarks.
No, I would happy if the callers could respond to some of the comments, and so we listen to them, and if you have extra time, we take it for calls only.
Two calls. Call you here. You are here. Hello?
Next one.
Call in here.
Hello?
Yes.
Good day.
Yeah.
Once again, I say congratulations to Mr. Jaipal, my good friend, child of the universe. Now, you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Somebody called in, just now with the NIS. I think that when you moderators on the program, they should come with a lot of information, because the information to respond to this caller is available. It is only last night news. The NIS has advised the public that the 10% increase for minimum pensioners are available from the 1st of March. The minister announced the increase for public servants, and there is a configuration that the NIS has to comply with, and they've complied with that. So the money has increased to $2,500 from January. But because of when it was announced, they could not pay from January. They have to put their arrangements in place. And they're paying from the 1st of March, but the NIS does not pay until the first Monday in the month. So the first Monday in the month is not the 1st of March, it's the 6th of March.
6th of March, yeah.
People can go with their ID card to the NIS and collect their books, which is stipulating the payment.
Okay. Or is it paid through the bank too?
Okay.
Yes. Once you're paying to the bank, they will send it to the bank.
Yes, okay.
Once you have the arrangement to them,
yeah,
send it to the bank.
Thank you very much.
I'm taking this opportunity, yeah, Minister, yeah, to remind you of that proposition I made with the tax compliance for the renewing of license for businesses. I know that you will try to push it, so I'm reminding you, okay?
Okay, and thank you. I know, look, there's opportunity for persons, not only because of their minister sitting, as the minister may have all the answers, so there's opportunity to the public, members of the public, with information to clarify any questions that's raised in this program.
No, you did
an excellent job in clarifying it. Thank you.
Also the persons who are moderators, like Mr. Sankeys and those other persons, to inform themselves about what is going on, because the information is available.
Yes, thank you.
Do not allow people to come in and mislead, and it become a propaganda where everybody believes that is true. Okay. Thank you very much.
No fake news.
And now we open the line for 3 minutes, 5 minutes more, 4 minutes more. 4 minutes more, we got to learn for. Yeah. Call in here. Hello?
Hello, Mr.
Yeah.
Drahman?
Yes.
Yes, how are you having
us,
Mr.
Drahman,
today on the station?
Why are you talking? Call in here, we are not busy now, you can run out of time. Yeah, call in here.
I was listening to a story.
Yes,
that,
yes.
Guy Paul.
Yes.
You know the struggle. We've been through the struggle. Tears come out of the struggle. All kind of things happen in the struggle. At one time you decide to quit because the struggle was tough. And what you realize that every time you ask me is that the opposition is spreading propaganda. And if you notice, the opposition are doing a better job than when we people were in opposition, because they could influence the people, even though that you are in government today. And when Yarlin was the opposition, Yarlin had him kind of swallow one of them for influence the people them. Now look at it from the other standpoint. You find that the same Gail Teixeira, what was she salary then? As the advisor or something like that?
Over a million, yes. 1.2 million. Yeah.
So what you got here today? And got here there, and the same woman, and propaganda about this same coalition that you are doing, the same people who want to beat your father, the same people who want to go down this station, the same people who the black man had to come out and represent your all from. And today what we see, we are making no sense to me.
No, where we have her, we didn't have her anywhere.
She's coming every Thursday.
Oh, we have her in the program. No, that is democracy.
It's not democracy.
Yes.
It's democracy for some people, but for me, concerned, that is making the black man a fool.
No, we don't want to be vindictive and bitter. Not the Justice for All Party. Not the Justice for All Party.
Our hard work. You want a day there for speak at no minister might be going back to America or going to find something else with your qualification. Because it is us. We are the people who went down there all night.
That's right. That's right. Yes.
And you know what we get for it? Not swallow while attack. Our minister doing this and the minister. We put the minister there. We got knowledge. Not that we are done.
Yes.
That's because the minister can run this stuff and do we eat like. We are the people. We are the voice. Look how much things we go through. Yeah. That this same station could have done there. When they burned down Metropole, he ain't got sent from that.
Yeah, and then not saying that.
When you look out there doing the fire, you left your black man, you see the head of like a crapple.
You ain't telling me no, man.
No, no, I got to answer your call. Yeah. Look.
Yes, hold on for me. Don't cut me up.
We cannot. Okay, we can answer the call.
Yes.
So, look, we want to quote the Bible when it's convenient. Yeah. I think a caller quote was Matthew 21. Yeah. 2021 verse.
The render scripture.
Yes, the render scripture.
Render
and
diseases.
So you got to render season what season God's what is God's. So you want to quote that. But when C.N. Sharma going to act like Christ himself when he said, if you slap on this cheek, turn the next cheek. So C.N. is not retaliative. He's not going to retaliate because they close him down, they beat him, they cuff him. As a result, he's ill today. He's not going to say, look, I'm going, because we are in government now, and you're in opposition, we will not give you airtime. He did it for the opposition then, and he's doing it for the opposition
now. Does it now.
Right? Yeah. So he's consistent. He's not going to use whatever bitterness he has in him to say, we'll not give them time. Understand that. Okay? So it's a principal position this party stands on, and not because we're in power, we're not going to give them advice. I told you when I was in opposition, that when we're going to put the PPP, because I know the PPP will lose the election, when they will be in opposition, they will be a strong opposition. I tell the opposition then, at various meetings, that when the PPP gets into office, when we get into office, the PPP in opposition, they will be a strong opposition. The PPP is the strongest political party in this hemisphere.
Yes.
The strongest. And there's a very strong opposition party. Why then? We were in opposition, we are punished. We were not given airtime and NCN. But why are you attacking CN for putting Gail here? This administration also say that the opposition will have airtime on the government TV station.
Hmm.
Okay? So even this government take a similar position like the leader of the Justice for All Party in terms that, look, we have to open up this thing. Okay?
Yes.
So we have to be fair. We can't live with bitterness. And, of course, they have the propaganda side. The PPP armed themselves. When in office and they give all that radio frequency to themselves, they was preparing for leave. They was preparing to go in the opposition, and they had to ensure that they control the airwaves, the radio and television, the newspaper, print media. They have print media on the side. They have the radio station on the side and have television station on the side. So they have that armed themselves. That is why they're so prepared more than us. But I agree with you, we're not offering any excuse, but then we cannot say this is a revenge thing. Because this propaganda that the PPP is spreading, that we going after foreign ministers and workers, probably secretaries of the previous administration and supporters of the previous administration, will hold water. You're gonna believe is a revenge thing. It's not a revenge thing. I'm responsible for forensic audit, and if the forensic audit point in direction and say a foreign minister was involved, the property secretary was involved, the friend was involved, I have to go after them. But if CN Sharma going to take the PPP off his program, and the government going to say, don't give them no program on the government station, then to the world it will be seen as we are fighting them down with bitterness and vindictiveness, and we can't allow that. So I know your anger.
Got it.
I know your anger. Could feel it.
Yes.
I think it's a passing of the buck.
Yes.
For schools and for water and light is unconstitutional.
Okay.
But take it to
court. I think that I will have to file a motion on this.
Okay.
Actually, because
The
act under which taxation is done, to set the article.
Yes.
Does not empower the state to pass this kind.
We can't talk about all the time, Mr. Jose. We can't talk about all the time now. We have to run out of time.
If
Trump
is saying
I'm saying, look.
This is Barajagil's problem. Why didn't you pass the act now? It is only the ordinary majority that put it in effect. Why fool the people? Why tell them you're Barajagil's pension? Why you don't stop it now? You can pass an ordinary act.
No.
Stop it. You're the only people, man. Because you can pass an act to stop the Barajagil pension by an ordinary majority. Why you don't do that?
Okay, thank you.
There's another point. There's other point that
he wants more.
That if you say, if you say that you interpret article for the appointment of the chairman of the election commission, and that Serge Bali was wrongly elected, therefore the government is unconstitutional because Serge Bali was there by virtue of an unconstitutional position. Why are you pulling the people? I have to bring some motion in the court.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Mr. Hussein, his own political party, and look, you're a lawyer, constitutional lawyer, well-trained in Canada, and you're free to bring any motion to challenge anything.
Yes. Wow. Okay. Let me go on, call him on here.
Oh, my.
Call him here, call him here, please. Yes. Yes, yes. Okay. We're going to wrap it up. What would you like to say, finally?
I'm just happy to be here and listen to the views of the general public and, the, of course, the bitterness of the opposition. Look, I was at the anniversary. We celebrating the 100 years of being indentureship being abolished, and we had the National Cultural Center. We have the Prime Minister performing the duty of President sitting there. We have myself and Minister Kati. And so many diplomats, ambassadors, and the PPP supporters and the representative came up to make their presentation, and it was sheer bitterness. These people are still bitter with the British. You can imagine how bitter they are with us as government. And so, you know, I think it sent the wrong message. I hope that the opposition will not continue along these lines to use this period of celebration to cause division in this country.
Pastor Mark, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Jabal, thank you very much. Sangi, thank you very much.
You know, you know, television and even a school is like a refrigerator. Take a look inside. There's things you like and there's things you don't like. And some of the things you don't like might be good for you to see and might be good for you to eat. So what's the point? We have to keep learning. We have to keep learning and realize that maybe in the long run, some of the things we've talked about in tax, it just might be good for you. This is Voice of the People. The people have spoken today on CNS TV, soon to celebrate 25 years of broadcasting. They keep going former.
Thank you,
Sharma.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much. Thank you very much.
Go forward. See you next week.
Have a nice day. God bless you all. Have a nice day.